Good morning, and it's blue. Welcome to the Black Mesa Transit System.
Hello.
This automated train is provided for the comfort and convenience.
As you can see, Half-Life again. I am Darren Goggett, and this is the continuing saga of quick rinses within the Half-Life universe. This is Blue Shift, an expansion sort of add-on that was released, you know, roughly near the time. And it sort of gives you the point of view from Barney's perspective. One of the Barneys, do you know what I mean? Like, there's about a million Barneys, as I said before. And it takes on a similar theme by, taking the train into work. And I decided to show this one because I'm pretty sure not many people either remember this being the intro to Blue Shift or have seen it at all. So we're taking this opportunity to take a little tram ride in. I don't think it's as long and not boring, but you know, okay, boring as the original Half-Life one. I say boring. I've got my tongue in my cheek there because what's he playing? Praxwalk. Don't know what that means. And I say boring with my tongue in my cheek because it's not really that boring, really. I used to love that. That used to give me a nerd boner like no other. The fact that the rails join together. And, definitely the era of gaming where everything seemed magical again. And yeah, throughout the whole of Blue Shift, you'll see like things happen that happen in Half-Life from a different perspective. So you'll see Gordon Freeman jumping into a certain teleporter. You'll see Gordon Freeman do this and that. And it's only one of the few games where you get to see Gordon Freeman outside of Gordon Freeman's sort of body. And I don't think Valve had that intention at the time of keeping, you know, you are Gordon Freeman. I'm sure they had it a little bit, but they weren't so intent on keeping it. Because like in Half-Life 2 Episode 1 and 2, you never leave the body of Gordon Freeman. So I'm sure there was a bit of a like, if they could retcon this game, they would never like do this expansion, which I'm sort of grateful they did because it's good fun. Or they would do this expansion today if they were to retcon it, but you wouldn't see Gordon Freeman, you'd just hear about it, or you know, you'd hear about it on a radio or someone told you. And this was sort of like groundbreaking at the time, but there was like a new type of policeman. Look, there he is.
Friends like you, man. Hey, Calhoun. Looks like we're in for a long day today. Have a good one, Calhoun.
I think I play as a Barney. Yeah, Barney Calhoun.
Now transferring to the Sector C line of the transit system. This is a medium security area of the Black Mesa facility. Be sure to wear your identification badge at all times.
We're going deeper underground. And again, it's just like these little touches at the start of the game, like tell you who you are, you know, what assignment you're on. You know, what your job is. Clearance level 3. It's pointless, but again, it's all immersion. I've got a feeling we can smell a G-Man sighting somewhere. Little forklift truck workers there, doing their thing. Ah, this is the bit where Gordon Freeman come in. Is Gordon Freeman on that train there? Because you'd see a Barney banging on the door here. Boom, 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 boom. Hang on, is that... That's me, innit? It's like a revelation all over again for me, to be honest. Ah, oh, technology moving forward, there were stairs popping out. So that Barney you see...
Hold on a minute. The door's not responding to your pass ID. Let me see if I can get it open on this...
That Barney you see at the start of Half-Life 1, which you would be in this tram here... Ah, oh, it's all coming together. It's like Lost at the end, but not rubbish. And there's Gordon Freeman, look, again, he's sort of like juddering around and it's a bit glitchy, but you never see him. You never see him. I'm so happy right now. And that's the Barney. Oh, the games are amazing. It's alright, mate.
We've been having problems.
I'm the same as you, though.
This morning. System crashes, security malfunctions. It's a wonder this whole place hasn't shut down yet.
This probably isn't canon in this game, but it should be. Hello, mate. You look suspiciously like me and the other guy. There. So if we look at these, we've got the HE Particle Labs down there, refreshments and Area 3 Security. So I've got Area 3 Pass, haven't I? So if we go down here, if Follow this green line. Follow the green line. Like a whole new area of Black Mesa that no one's ever seen.
I can't access my files. I can't answer my mail. I haven't even been able to get into my office.
Shut up, Clarny, you're boring.
I know, sir, I know.
The old classic elevator noises. I love this era of gaming, where it all just feels so... Oh, it's got its own vibe to it, you know? Like Quake, this is obviously the Quake engine, a modified Quake engine, but it just feels like Quake and Doom and... Oh! They don't make them like they used to! They do, they make them better. But I do like the game, this game's vibe.
How's it going?
It's alright, mate. What are you reading?
Here you go, Calhoun.
I swear that gun was bigger on the desk than it is, man.
Schedule for a couple more days, but if you want to squeeze in a few shots in the range, there's plenty of room.
Of course I do. Twin. Not a twin. Fatty. Go on, eat it, mate. Go on, you can do it. He's struggling with that, isn't he? What is he doing? What is he doing? I'm worried for him. Really want to start popping off rounds, to be honest. Oh yeah, you can bring the thing over, can't you? Come on, shoot me! Oh! Oh, sorry. Oh, that actually made me jump. I'm sorry if I just burst your eardrums or something. And that genuinely made me jump. Right, I'm done. Let's get out of here. He did call me crazy, to be fair. But I didn't think he'd actually call me crazy and then shoot me. You know what I mean? I was sort of a bit of a shock to the system. I've been here, haven't I? Brrr. I know this isn't very long. I remember completing it in the day I got it.
Nice of you to show up this morning, Calhoun. Yeah, I know. Problems with the access system. Hope you're ready for a long shift.
You could say a blue shift, because it's going to be like sad and stuff, and the fact that policemen's are blues. There we go, we've seen this before, haven't we? Hood. Lombardi! 10 points if you know who that is. Calhoun. It's like my own HEV, but not. The truth about aliens, government conspiracies, someone doing something, and someone's girlfriend. That's, I wonder, when they do things like this, when they put real images in games, it looks, obviously it looks weird, but I'd love to know what they look like now. Where's Gabe Newell's locker then? Has he not got one? It's probably in there, it's probably broke the toilet. Boo, Duke Nukem Lab and cheese showers. Yeah.
Uh-oh, now what? Looks like some people are having problems with the main access lift in Sector G. Why don't you go over there?
G-Man. I don't know where Sector G is. Already you can see the flaws in the design of this sort of blue shift map pack or whatever you like to call it, because it's not as well directed as the original Half-Life, because I don't know what I'm doing. If I don't find this soon, I'm clearly just going to quit out and stop the quick rinse, because it's boring to see me run back and forth along the same places, but I'd love to see what's going on. Sector G, the lift's broken down, let's go and find it. Dun, 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 dun. Let's see what else he's got to say for himself. Nothing.
I'm a little busy right now, Calhoun.
Yeah, you look it, mate. You just stand there, yeah? It's got to be past here, innit? Yeah, now I've got my vest
Have
on.
A good one, Calhoun.
The old thing of foresight, you know, when you see things, people tell you stuff before it's happened, you know. When he says have a good one, you know you're not going to have a good one because I've seen the game before. I love that. It was like primitive sort of conversation between NPCs before, you know, anything like happened. And it didn't make any sense. Like, it'd say one thing and they'd come up with a generic answer. But it was so...
If you're waiting for the tram to Sector G, then you're probably better off walking it. I overheard someone say that all the trams on this end of the facility are having problems.
Whoa. The hell was that? This is interesting. See, Gordon Freeman should have blown stuff up by now, but because I've been knobbing around for a little while, it hasn't kicked off just yet. I don't know what I'm doing. Get out of my way. Listen to those sounds, man. They're great. And this was another great feature about the expansion. It was sort of, again, like a different take, even though he's sort of skitting out, he's juddering around. It's sort of a different take on, you know, the Half-Life story. And new features like bridge things lowering down and stuff that you never saw in the original Half-Life game. I mean, I'm sure it's going to come down now. Here we go. You never saw that in the original game. It was just cool to see the world from a different perspective. Sort of like GTA 4 in there, like Lost and Damned and stuff, when you see Nico crossing past you and stuff like that. Yeah. Sector G. Man. G-Man. Oh. As if anyone would walk on there. Look, it's a walkway suspended by... Oh. Not cool.
Well, it's about time. We don't pay you people to mosey around at your own convenience.
Oh, shut
Make
up.
This thing work so we can get on with this miserable day.
Was that all? We had to press a button? You scientists, man. You might be clever, but you've got no common sense, have you? Oh, look at me. I can do biology. And I can jump up and down like this. Oh, look at me. I can do science. Oh. Oh!
It's probably those anomalous materials people again.
Oh.
Pushing their equipment too hard, dabbling in who knows what. I'd be surprised if there's one good brain among them.
Ah, oh dear!
I mean, I didn't shoot anyone. Well, that's the end of the quick rinse. Obviously, games have, games haven't aged as well as some, and that is a prime example of the sort of like the physics, the source. No, this isn't source, is it? It's quite impressive because it's the original version, but yeah, it's a prime example of old physics not working well with today's hardware, and the fact that he was juddering around and got killed by the elevator before he was supposed to. I then got terminated, and yeah, that has been Blue Shift. Thank you for watching, and it's quite interesting, but I think we've seen all the interesting parts, so yeah, I have been Darren Coggett, and come back for Opposing Force quick rinse. Thank you.